So how did you get the air pressure to build back up? Because you didn't have enough. What did you do?
We have the cage here. It'll fluctuate.
4 years ago, my partner, Kim Butala, and I came together and really felt like we could do a little bit more for the students here at Chardon High School. We decided to try a new program, and luckily our district was on board, and that's how the crew started.
Does it here?
Yeah.
It stands for Creating Reliable Educated Workers.
Let's do this.
We really just started as a classroom, and after diving in and really getting to know the community in a different way, we found out that there was a huge need in our area for manufacturing.
Are you sure those locks are aligned?
Yeah. We cover everything from AC/DC electrical wiring, pneumatics, hydraulics, all the way up to smart manufacturing, the tabletop mechatronics, so sensors and programmable logistics and everything that goes into it.
I enjoy being a part of this program because it really gives us a lot of great opportunities while learning about machines and programs that interest us.
The alternating and direct, it's definitely going to be how it's used and the capacity, right?
It's not only teaching me about the actual equipment, it's teaching me problem solving, working with others, kind of like if something goes wrong, figure it out, learn from trial and mistake, you know?
Some of my favorite parts definitely include the skills boss I demonstrated today. It gets me a lot of hands-on problem solving work, because it's not like we have a step-by-step of how to put it back together and take it apart. It's a lot of trial and error and a lot of you do it, you figure it out yourself.
It's fun because it's almost like a puzzle where you gotta like solve for one thing and then you're like, oh, this will work, and then it doesn't work, but then you gotta figure it out.
That makes sense, doesn't it? That
yeah.
When it's on the alternating, you're feeling that vibration.
But as we go on, they also give us opportunities to do job shadows and internships to get real world experience.
We do a lot of visits and we go out and we see what's happening. And it's great because as we walk through, we're like, hey, do you see that? Do you see that sensor? Do you see that? Everything that's happening in here, they're able to see out there and they're able to make those connections.
What we're learning here will actually be on real life job sites that we may be working on.
We have four young men who were in our program last year. Partway through the year, going through the program, they were able to land jobs. You know, we were able to place them in manufacturing. We were able to place them out. They were all seniors. They continued to come to class, work on their credentialing, learning as much as they could. Those four young men, once graduation day hit, they were employed full time. They've continued to grow within their positions, within their companies. They're all fully employed, and we feel that's a huge success. You know, we found out about SACA, and I'm one of those people, I'm like, oh, pick me, I'll do that. Really, everything's been for the kids. So it's, how can we help the students? Is adding one more layer gonna help the students? Then we're willing to do it. Buckeye and Amatrol have been there to support us. SACA's been fantastic, finding out more about SACA, getting those credentials, getting those certifications for the kids. Through SACA, we are now working to get them college credits. So if they can stack these credentials, it will equate to these CCP courses that are offered to other kids. And a lot of our kids never saw themselves going to college. So if we can pair the hands-on and those credentials with some college credits for them, it's opening up a whole new door. Now they're seeing themselves in a different light, which I think is what this is all about.
It definitely gives me more options and kind of helps me lean towards what I want to do, because I really enjoy what I do here.
Watching them grow, watching them struggle, work through the struggle, find that grit within themselves has been amazing.
It's going to make this light turn green.
We were able to get 24 students SACA credentials last year here in the classroom, so that's another huge success for us. And they're able to take those out in the community. And our community partners are really interested in the credentialing and what the kids are bringing to them. We are in a perfect place. Everything we do is going to transfer out to the rest of the state for our kids.